One of the most common things that people always ask on my videos is where to buy photo books. And I've listed resources before. I often recommend buying directly from a publisher. So Mac, Stanley Barker, Steidl, any of these like popular photo book publishers. That's a great place to order books from, but I'm all about supporting small business. And there's a brand new photo book shop opening up in Baltimore. They specialize in photo books and zines, and it's also a gallery space. And it's being opened up by one of my really good friends, Kyle Miles. I had him on my podcast years ago, so maybe you're familiar with him through there. Kyle's a great photographer and has a great eye for kind of curating all of these different kind of photo books and different zines. So what I wanted to do is place an order through his online store, so you don't have to be in Baltimore. You can actually just order directly through him and he'll ship it to you, which is great. So I'm gonna go ahead, open up some books here, kind of talk a little bit about the books as well, and give you guys a little bit more information on Baltimore Photo Space. Kyle is not sponsoring this video. He didn't even want me to do this kind of thing because he's very humble and shy and just doesn't like being, you know, center of attention. But this is what it's all about. When friends are doing something really cool, I want to make sure I kind of put a spotlight on that. And again, people are always asking, you know, for a good place to buy photo books from. So let's get into it. So this box arrived last night, and when I was placing the order, I tried to get somewhat of a decent variety based on the descriptions. One of the books is a book I've wanted for a really, really long time, and the other two books I'd never even heard of. So that's another good thing. Supporting a place like this where they're gonna have good variety, and it's not just, you know, you're not looking specifically for one genre or one particular photographer's work. Just browsing on the site, it was cool because I saw a lot of books that I'd never even heard of, and inevitably added a bunch of other books to my wish list. So the first book is Teju Cole's Fernway. This is a book and photographer I'd never heard of. And on the back here, I was just taking off the shrink wrap and I realized there's like a little bit of information. It says, taken from the German word for a longing to be elsewhere, Fernway presents color photographs made across Switzerland over a 5-year period, offering a distinctly new way to envision a country that has been the quintessence of tourist experiences for almost 2 centuries. Teju Cole is a photographer and noted novelist and essayist. This book was published by Mac, which again is a publisher I'm regularly like looking through their online store and seeing what books they're putting out. I'm gonna go ahead and read the description from the website, that way you get a little bit more information on the book. The picturesque vistas and apparent stability of Switzerland have made it an elusive subject for contemporary photography. Over a 5-year period from 2014 to 2019, Cole found a distinctly new way to look at a country that has been the quintessence of tourist experience for almost 2 centuries. Fernway muses on the German word for a longing to be elsewhere. Cole's meditative and scrupulously composed work made with color film is evocative of the hidden history of the Alpine nation as well as of its highly curated terrain. Returning to Switzerland year after year, Cole shares the patience and mild palette of luminaries of contemporary European photography, but the constructivist tension in these images is all his own. With photographs shot in every corner of the country, from Vaud to Graubünden to Lugano, terribly sorry if I mispronounced any of that, Fernway creates a vision of Switzerland that, through largely devoid of human presence, is rich in human traces, none more so than Cole's own distinct way of seeing. Definitely looking forward to spending more time with this one and like really dissecting it and getting a better feel for it. Next up, we have something from Deadbeat Club. This is Rabbit Hair, and this is like a joint or split zine book. This, I would consider this a book, from David Billett and Ian Klein. This is one that I've never heard of, and when I asked Kyle about it, he was like, yeah, this one is right up your alley, you'll love it. David Billett and Ian Klein made the pictures in Rabbit Hair on a road trip to Texas, and right away that statement is going to create a certain set of expectations among viewers of this book. Perhaps no other region in the United States comes with such a strong set of preconceived notions. So yes, you'll see 10-gallon hats, a wayward Confederate flag, even a baptism in a watering trough. But the real glory of Rabbit Hair is how surely its makers have defied easy stereotypes. These pictures do not derive their palpable life from mere subject matter. In this book, butterflies and back hair are equally magical and mundane as they should be. Qualities of light are equally qualities of sensibility. The human beings in the pictures gently revel in the pleasures of riding horses or smoking cigarettes or exposing skin to sun and air. And similarly, we see Billet and Klein revel in their intuition and in the quality of their inquiry. They share not only their delight in seeing a cat or a bird enjoying the light, but somehow also the very delight experienced by the animal itself. We understand the intimate physical communion of some ragtag street wrestlers not because of the description, but rather because of the evocation of sweat and muscles and asphalt. Rabbit hair will not tell us anything about how to evaluate any particular state or region or electorate. What we instead see is how to meet the world with open minds and open hearts and to make something lasting of that meeting. This is such a strange and like interesting like combination of photos. Like the whole, you know, road trip through Texas, like they mentioned in the description, you're automatically going to start thinking of what you might see, but this is a totally different kind of approach. I am really, really excited to spend more time with this one because this looks like right up my alley. Good call, Kyle. Last but not least, something that I think everybody has in their collection, but I have just now added it. Alex Oth, Sleeping by the Mississippi. This is like his most famous body of work, I think. At least in a lot of people's eyes, it's probably the most popular. I've wanted an Alex Oth book for a long time, and it's not like they've been hard to find because, you know, this is like the second edition, I think second printing of this book as well. I could have gotten it a long time ago, along with like Songbook and other books of his that I've always wanted, but for whatever reason, I'm just now buying my first Alex Oth book. Don't hate me, but I'm super excited about it to finally have this one in the collection. Sleeping by the Mississippi by Alex Oth is one of the defining publications in the photo book era. First published by Steidl in 2004, it was Soth's first book, sold through 3 print runs, and established him as one of the leading lights of contemporary photographic practice. This is the second printing of the Mac edition and includes 2 new photographs that were not included in the Steidl versions of the book. Evolving from a series of road trips along the Mississippi River, Sleeping by the Mississippi captures America's iconic yet often neglected Third Coast. Soth's richly descriptive large format color photographs present an eclectic mix of individuals, landscapes, and interiors. Sensuous in detail and raw in subject, Sleeping by the Mississippi elicits a consistent mood of loneliness, longing, and reverie. In the book's 46 ruthlessly edited pictures, writes Ann Wilkes Tucker in the original essay published in the book, Soth alludes to illness, procreation, race, crime, learning, art, music, death, religion, redemption, politics, and cheap sex. Like Robert Frank's classic, The Americans, Sleeping by the Mississippi merges a documentary style with poetic sensibility. The Mississippi is less the subject of the book than its organizing structure. Not bound by a rigid concept or ideology, the series is created out of a quintessentially American spirit of wanderlust. 16 years since the book was first published, the artist's lyrical view has undoubtedly acquired a nuanced significance, one in which hope, fear, desire, and regret coalesce in the evocative journey along this mythic river. I feel like my gut reaction a lot of times when I see like a certain scene or something that I want to take a photo of, I immediately start getting really close. And one thing I've like learned over time of just looking at Alex Oth's work is realizing that I don't have to be right up on something. Like sometimes some of those little things that I would just immediately want to like cut out of the frame and get close enough so I don't see any distractions. I'm learning more and more, like year after year, how much some of those small details can actually add rather than just distract. It's like my first kind of gut instinct is to minimize and get rid of any like unnecessary clutter. And I mean, I think that's a good thing, but again, sometimes I feel like I might be cropping out things that could help tell the full story. Yeah, like he includes so much in every single scene that I would inevitably want to crop some of this stuff out, but I think, you know, it's a good thing that he didn't in some of these. Not much else to say about Sleeping by the Mississippi. I mean, it's a famous and iconic photo book, one that I probably should have added to my collection many, many years ago, but nonetheless, it's here now. So these are three new books I just picked up from Baltimore Photo Space. Again, brand new photo book and gallery space opened up in Baltimore, and of course everything online right now. Anybody who wants to pick up a book, definitely make this a new place that you browse and search through as you're looking for new photo books, because sometimes I'll find a new book that might kind of pique my interest and it's from somebody else who either texts me about it, or I might see another photographer post about the book and that'll pique my interest. But just regularly, like essentially window shopping online at places like Stanley Barker and Mac and all of these publishers, make sure you go to baltimorephotospace.com anytime you're looking for new photo books, because you're going to have a pretty wide variety, everything from photo books to zines and from all different kinds of publishers. It's a really, really cool thing. And again, it's a photographer, a great photographer. He's one of us. Like, he's doing something for the community, and I think we should like support people like that financially. You know, if you're regularly buying photo books, you should support another photographer who's doing it just for the love of photo books. So Kyle's a really good dude. I hope you guys support him, as I'm going to continue to be buying books through his shop. Any chance you get, support small business, support other photographers. Hope you guys enjoyed this look at these books. Again, baltimorephotospace.com if you're interested in any of these or any other books. Just definitely take some time and check it out. That's it for today, though. Thank you guys for everything. I love you. I'll see you next time.